Hello, what's up, Power Morphicon Online? How are we doing today? Welcome to the Women of the Grid panel. I am Liz. I'm here on behalf of the Illuminati. So thank you so much for letting me host this. And I have two Power Rangers and one evil one. Here we get a two for one. But we also have, an action figure hero here as well.
Oh, that was pretty cool that they made my doll earlier this year. Yes.
Allie, do you have one yet?
Yeah, I do. I my husband like mass ordered a bunch of them. You know, it's kind of sad that they don't send them to us, I have to say. I'm like, hello, like, where's my doll or my figurine? So we ordered some right from Hasbro and they've arrived. So I've given them to all of my friends that have girls, because I think, it's pretty important to share with them that, they can dream big and do anything that they want to do and, fight the universe if they want to. So.
Absolutely. You could fight the universe, or you could try to take over the universe because Ms. Milt has a figure as well.
Oh, the reveal.
Except we have the hair. She gets blue hair.
That is so cool.
I got blue hair. So
We
that
have
was released kind of around the same time as you, only like in December-ish, I believe, right? So exciting, but I'm such a
It
nerd.
is.
Ordered one. I was like, I'm just gonna get one. And then I let my dad for safekeeping, and he'd get a kick out of it. So it's displayed proudly in his home.
Oh, that's awesome. Hey, some parents like display their kids' trophies. You know, be like, dude, my daughter has a an action figure. I would show everyone if my daughter had an action figure.
You know what's funny on that topic is so Greg Aronowitz, who was the executive producer of SPD and also director, he had a hookup with a gentleman named Drew Struzan, who used to draw all of the really cool, I think, Star Wars posters. Someone's gonna correct me if I'm wrong there. Anyway, amazing artist. So he drew this crazy poster of all of the SPD Power Rangers. And when we were in New Zealand filming, all the Power Rangers signed, their copy that they got. I gifted mine to my parents and had it all framed and matted. And it's been in their house for years. And they just moved. And my dad sends me a picture saying, hey, I have this. Do you want it? And I'm like, I am really offended right now because that is like the coolest thing. I thought you'd want to display that proudly for like the rest of your life, but yes, I'll take it back. Fine. I'll weirdly put it up in my own home, but
Not
anyway.
weird.
Yeah.
I guess that's better than like, hey, we're having a yard sale. Like, do you want to, how much do you think I could get for this? How much is your signature going for? Can we?
Right, true. Yeah.
That's one way to fix that. Women, I move I got boxes. You ladies have done some awesome stuff, right? You've gotten to be villains, you've gotten to be heroes and stuff, but like behind the spandex, not spandex, however it is. I just have some fun questions. Like, let's have Ranger Nation get to know you a little more beyond all of the what's your favorite episodes. I want to know what's your favorite brunch?
Eggs Benedict.
What's a drink though? What kind of like, let's say it's Sunday, it's brunch.
Mimosa, like, yeah.
I think I'm more of a like a chicken and waffles and like a latte followed by a Bloody Mary.
Ooh.
Get like a coffee intro.
That's good. You can always put like Bailey's in the coffee.
Oh wow, yeah.
You
That elevates that.
you should. Yes, it does. The waffles, they're so good.
Oh my
They're
God,
so good.
I had waffles this weekend. That's why it's like top of mind for me. Like chicken leg. Oh God.
Where did you grow up? Did you grow up like a chicken and waffle place, or was this like a new thing?
No, Northern California, but I did get it in San Francisco, so really good. But my dad is from North Carolina, so maybe there's kind of a
Mm-hmm.
I don't know an influence there.
And what, and Allie, are you from Canada?
Yeah, I'm Canadian. So I grew up.
Hey, that's why you're so polite.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I grew up on the East Coast, but I now live on the West Coast in Vancouver.
In Vancouver. Do you guys have any like regional delicacies of brunch? Like if you're like, oh, I ate a horseshoe for lunch, like would you have an idea what that meant?
No idea. No. Is that a thing?
Oh yeah, that's actually where I'm from. A horseshoe, it's two giant pieces of like Texas toast, right? So that's, and then I have to explain because I don't know if they have Texas toast again. It's really thick toast.
Yeah.
So two toasted slices of it, each has a hamburger patty on top of it. And then you cover it in a mound of French fries. Wow. And then you cover all of that in liquid cheese sauce.
Oh. Wow. That sounds like a week's worth of calories in one meal.
I could go a week after that.
it's not great. That's the horseshoe. That's the full. The Clydesdale is the three patty one. Look, we live in the Midwest here. We're not exactly. We hibernate for the winter.
Hey, you know what? Whatever makes you happy, like I said before, I think it's awesome. I think you should eat what you want to eat and enjoy life because life is too short, honestly. I think just have the Clydesdale if you want it.
I cannot eat the Clydesdale. That's too much food. That's too much food. So we've talked food. How about on a random, let's say it's a rainy day, you're going to binge watch TV. And I'm not saying you do not have to answer Power Rangers. There's no pandering in this one. I like, what do you just be like, I'm putting this on TV and I'm chilling.
Oh God, that's so hard. I feel like that was all of quarantine. Like, what do I pick? I don't even know.
Yeah, I think it depends what mood I'm in. Like, I love Handmaid's Tale. Big, big fan of that show, but it's a little bit dark. So you have to be in the mood to watch that. If it's like a light, nice day, or you said rain, but I mean, I'm a big sucker for all the like house hunting shows, or the vacation, like island, whatever, like, you know, and they're looking for to buy islands. Cause I think through quarantine, I put that on a lot cause it made me feel kind of like vacation vibes and something to look
I feel yeah.
And it made me feel happy. So I often watch a lot of those kind of travel house hunting, but like the tropical, you know, series.
Yeah, she's like, oh, one day I will never ever buy a house there.
Yeah. Although some of these places, I mean, maybe I am just, you know, traumatized, honestly, from Vancouver, the Vancouver housing market. But some of these places, I feel like we could buy an island for the cost of like a shed in Vancouver, right? So sometimes I dream about moving to some of these locations. Yeah.
Yeah, totally. I did a bender on Great British Baking Show for sure. Like I had like a minor crush on Paul Hollywood for like 5 minutes.
Did it inspire you? Did you try to bake at all afterwards?
I tried to make. I forgot what they were called. They were called like the something buns, but they're like these like British buns. It just did not pan out, literally. Like it was just like little tiny scrawny buns, and it wasn't like that failed.
That's all right. Did you guys like take up anything during quarantine, or did you just like try to stay sane?
Yeah, I went through phases personally where I did the whole banana bread sourdough kick, mm-hmm. where I'm like going to try to be Susie Homemaker since I'm home. And then I got into Peloton, and I think it was a roller coaster ride where I watched so much TV and mm-hmm. yeah, I think it was, mm-hmm. it was a mix of like trying to be healthy and active and then vegging out and like enjoying being stuck at home as much as I could.
That's an optimistic way of thinking of it.
Tried.
All of that, and then I would add meditation because I used to like keep from getting a little nuts. So I would do like online meditation with like an insight timer or something, like an app, you know.
Amazing.
And anything to help
sane, you know.
Stay sane.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I was gonna say, like, any new hobbies. I know people have like taken up some crazy things. You got a Peloton. I see the commercials for those things all the time. Those things are insane.
Yeah.
And like those are all like very healthy things that you did to try to get past it.
Liz, what did you do?
I have a 4.5-year-old and I have a husband who started working from home and his office is like next to her room. So it was a lot of just keeping myself sane and trying to raise a daughter where you can't go anywhere or do anything.
That's so tough.
Wow. That's tough. But did any of you guys have any kids or like nieces or anything?
I have 2 boys, 6 and 11. But you know, in Canada's a little bit behind the US. So our schools did close in March through June, the school year, but then they reopened in BC anyway, they reopened in September. I know parts of Canada, they're still doing online learning, virtual learning. And I mean, we went through that from March to June and oh my word, like I trying to run a business, homeschool my children, keep sane and keep everyone happy and healthy. It was a lot. So September when schools reopened, I was thrilled because it's a lot to be home. And like you'd said, like you can't really do much and try to keep kids busy. It was challenging.
Gives you a ton of respect for the teachers because
right?
No way. I'm like, I have one. I don't know. It's fine. You can, everybody deal with your own.
Yeah. And like kindergarten, my son's in kindergarten. So how do you keep kindergarten students, you know, hold their attention over Zoom? Kudos to the teachers for doing their best and trying to at least keep our kids occupied online so we could have a little bit of a break as parents. Yeah. But
I admire you both. Like I know that parents kind of probably hate hearing this, but it's like I truly don't know how you did it. I mean, I feel like I struggled just with myself, let alone like a family or children that you have to keep in line and inside and safe. I just,
the hug, man. It's the hug, like at the end of the night and that like, I love you, mommy. You're like, all right. Like that's all it's for. So speaking of superheroes, if you ladies could swap and be different superheroes, like not Power Rangers, you would go be like, I want to be a female captain, or I want to be Captain Marvel, or maybe you want to be like She-Hulk or something. Like, is there another character that you're like, I would love to be that for a day? Yeah. Or to take their powers?
Yeah.
Oh my God. I don't know. I feel like I'm just going to confess that I never have a good answer for this kind of thing. I'm like, I don't know. And actually, Captain Marvel is the one thing in my brain, but now I can't say it because you said it. But like, I'm so bad at this kind of stuff.
Captain America?
Isn't it like
Captain Marvel and Captain America? Is that different?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Captain Marvel's the girl. Captain America's the guy.
Oh,
I didn't even. Miss Marvel is also a girl. They ran out of words at one point in Marvel. And so this is where chat's like, okay, Liz. Okay.
Well, I'm going to pick Wonder Woman because, you know, I think she rocks. I liked Wonder Woman 1 more than 2, but I'm going to go with Wonder Woman.
She was last. I feel like even the original Wonder Woman.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's iconic.
Or the Bionic Woman. She was also amazing. So I don't know. The 70s, 80s. Like, I don't know.
Especially like Charlie's Angels, they didn't really have like superpowers, but they kicked butt.
Yeah, they could kick ass for sure. But I think I'd want to like fly and like kick ass, like hardcore kick ass if I could pick.
Yeah. I think like Catwoman would be cool for a bit. Or even like Spider-Gwen, because I like Spider-Man powers. You can just kind of fly around, like you don't have to deal with traffic. You can just like get here and there really quick.
Yeah.
That would be amazing. Or be Superman. So the only disguise you need is to put glasses on.
Right. How funny is that?
The what?
Such an easy costume change.
Yeah. Right. Right. And then he just rips his clothes off. And then someone behind him is like, there's a man running around naked. Like, do you see this pile of clothes here? Like, what is going on? These are the strange thoughts that go through my head. Do you guys play any games or anything? Like, even like solitaire? Do you play, I don't know, like phone games or anything? I don't anymore. I'm thinking of old ones, like Angry Birds and I'm not hip.
Not really phone games. We're a big board game family. And also through COVID, my kids got into Fortnite. Huge Fortnite fans. And I started to play with them and they thought it was really cool when I would play with them. And then I just, it was over my head. They're actually so good. And I like building and all that, like I can't keep up. So I don't play with them anymore, which I maybe should, but board games, yes. Video games, yes. Not so much like apps.
I have nothing to add to that. I feel like the stuff for me is like yoga and HIIT classes and yeah. I'm not sure. Get into it. I feel like it'd be really good. Like it's good brain exercises.
Well, sometimes it's good brain. Sometimes it's good for the mental health when you're like, die, aliens, die.
Yeah, but there is such a thing as too much time on, on video games. I can confirm that just because I have a timer now for my kids or they would literally be on there for 12 hours. So, yeah.
Every day. Yeah. I have that, my kid and my husband. No, I'm just kidding. He doesn't have a timer. He just...
I wouldn't believe you if you did.
kids are kids of any ages. I think I'm proof of that here. Although I mean we're all like I'm an older fan. I'm 34, you know. It's like the older, and I guess that's why I didn't want to ask so many like other Power Ranger like favorite episodes and stuff, because I just want to get to know like as like woman to woman, I guess, like we're older, like to just kind of get to know you, like who you are behind the mask, behind everything, like what are your interests and what do you like to do, and I don't know, just things like that. And so you could probably edit that out. I'm sorry, I also have a head cold right now, so I'm a little like
you're making it quiz.
That's thanks. But yeah, I was gonna say back to COVID, but all of us, we kind of survived. What are you planning on doing now once things are opening up? Like, what are you most looking forward to going out and doing?
Traveling. Oh my goodness, I cannot wait. I mean, I feel not everyone can relate to this yet because, like I said, Canada's a little bit behind, so we can't, our borders aren't open, we can't. Essentially, we can leave Canada, but if we come back, we're stuck in a 14-day quarantine. So no one's really leaving right now because it's just not worth it. But sounds like soon the borders will be opening up. We can travel without having to quarantine upon return. So I want to get on an airplane and I want to go somewhere tropical. First of all, I want to see people. I want to party. I want to hug people. I want to have a big backyard barbecue and like hug all of my friends. And you know, I feel like everyone, it's going to be like the roaring 20s, honestly, soon here with these epic parties and social activities and just jet setting. And oh, I want to do it all.
Just ready to get out.
Yeah. Let me out.
I do wonder about that because I have the same feelings. I can't wait to travel and be just like in the same room as my friends. But I wonder if it's going to be more of like an incremental process because like, will we just be like, yay, let's just all hang out together and hug? Or is it going to be are we going to be a little bit hesitant? You know, it's just going to be a strange world to navigate, I think, in the first months.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a little bit of PTSD for sure from this past year. So it might be a little bit of a transition period. Yes, but I feel like eye on the prize is to get back to, you know, normal and be able to hug our friends without feeling fearful. But I do agree. I think it'll take a little bit of warming up.
And I just know for myself, like I think socially I'm going to have to like remember, I think there's going to be this like reintegration period when we're like, ah, this is what this conversation is like in real time, in person. Like, I think there will be that transition from being isolated to just being like random small talk at a party, you know?
So what stage are you both at right now in COVID? Like, what are you kind of free to roam as you please? Like, what are the restrictions like in your areas?
I'll go first. I live in Missouri, which is, I don't know, depends where you go, the wild, wild west. Right now we are, masks are not mandatory, but they're recommended if you haven't gotten the vaccine, but it's kind of being lifted everywhere. And where some, like our St. Louis Cardinals or big baseball team, they just opened up to full capacity. So places are starting to really open up again. It's just that waiting for like, oh yeah, my kids can't get, you know, my daughter can't get the vaccine yet. So you still have a bit of that hesitancy, but a lot of things are slowly getting back to normal here.
Okay. California opened, I believe, yesterday. So I think, barring special circumstances, people can largely go maskless unless you're not vaccinated. But I think it is going to be hard to kind of navigate that, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's pretty exciting. I saw fireworks last night.
Yay!
Well, great.
It's the little thing sometimes, right? Like, you can just go outside and you're seeing, like, I saw a group of friends playing basketball together at the park and you're just like,
yeah, yeah, for sure.
Is there that either of you established during COVID that you wish to take with you, that going forward, like any discoveries?
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like the balance, you know, I feel personally, I put a lot of pressure on myself. It didn't come from anywhere else to hustle all the time. You know, I worked so much and it was go, 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 go. And this was a forced pause. And to be honest, I don't want to go back to the pace that I was at, you know, pre-COVID. I think that I've learned personally how to balance home life and work better through this process. So I'm going to take that with me and learn to say no, you know, for anything that doesn't serve me or anything that doesn't make me happy. I think it's okay to say no and, you know, leave room for the things that you really want to do. So that's my biggest learning.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. I think I've learned that I can do it. Like, just one foot in front of the other, you know, it doesn't matter. Just, you can do it. It's, you know, deep breaths and, you know, some of the, like, the fears and the, like, being stuck at home and the whatever. It's like, look, at the end of the day, everyone in your house is still alive. They've all been fed. Everybody went to bed okay. Like, it's okay. And so, and, you know, to, like, kind of, like, reevaluate, like, home and family, you know, everything around you is crumbling. It's like, you know, recenter back to just, you know, my mom, my sisters, you know, my family, just, it was kind of nice being able to rely on other people like that. And then now it's like our relationships are, oh, you know, almost in a way even stronger. And so now that the restrictions are being lifted, it's like, oh my God, I can't wait to go, you like, see my sister and see my nieces and just those things that you would take for granted before that I really don't want to take for granted again.
What about you, Elodie?
I agree with both of you. I think, and I think that so many people are reflecting on what their work life looks like now. You know, like those of us who are being sort of like, are we going to get called back to the office and what will that look like? Or, you know, I think a lot of people are sort of demanding more balance. Mm-hmm. And it's like when you're spending 2 hours commuting every day, maybe that's not ideal anymore. So I think sort of rewriting what that looks like is an exciting prospect.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It is going forward. I've seen a lot of people like reevaluating their jobs. Like, instead of going back, can I find a place where I work remotely? Because that home life, and it doesn't say you have to have a husband and kids to say, I want 2 hours of my life back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to devote to whatever you were wanting. There are words there. I promise. They work sometimes. So both of you, you've done conventions and stuff before. they're gonna be opening up back again. Is that like a let's get back into it, or are you a little like, I don't know, in place? Well, I guess with you, Allie, it depends if you can leave the country or not. So you might.
Yeah, I think that I'm hoping to go to Power Morphicon in person next year.
Next year, yeah.
And then I'm also committed to going to Orlando in June. I think it's Anime Fest.
Cool.
So I'll do a couple next year. I don't think I'll be doing anything this year, but I'll do a couple next year. I normally only do a couple every couple of years. I'm not huge on the convention scene, but definitely enjoy the process and meeting everybody in person. I think that, honestly, I still have those pinch me moments when so many fans come up and have literally watched every episode of every Power Ranger series. And I feel like I owe it to them to show up sometimes and to meet them, because I'm grateful that they still love the show and they still love our series. And I do love meeting everyone. It's just a matter of, I don't want to overdo it. And I'll just show up now and again.
they're exhausting.
They can be long days, but they're a lot of fun. And then I get to meet fellow Power Rangers too, and other characters in the series. And it's so neat to see them in person. I know my kids are huge Power Ranger fans. Actually, they were supposed to come with me to Power Morphicon last year. And they were dying. Like they couldn't wait. And obviously SPD is not their favorite series. So this doll, for example, my 6-year-old who's in kindergarten, once a month they get show and tell and in their special helper. So on the first of this month, my husband suggested, well, you could take the SPD Power Ranger doll as show and tell. Like, your mummy has a figurine. She was a Power Ranger. He was like, no, I want to take a sticky hand.
Oh my God, that's such a kid.
And I'm like, okay, you take the sticky hand. Like, yeah. So, but they, anyways, I want to get back to a convention that they can come to, because I can't wait to see it through their eyes. I think that'll be full circle.
That's what season. So what seasons are they watching?
I don't even really know them. Ninja Storm. I don't even know the name.
Are they like dinosaur ones?
Yeah, there's a dinosaur one. There's a couple that they watch over and over. I can see the characters in my mind, but I just don't know what. Just on Netflix, they watch a couple of the same series over and over that they love, and it's not SPD. So
that's
yeah.
Do they ever get that you're like, look, mommy was a Power Ranger, okay? Like, even just once, be like, you know what?
Yeah.
You know what?
Yeah. When he didn't want to take my, normally I've been quite humble about it and haven't really talked a ton about it. It's mainly been like my husband showing them on Netflix, like mommy was a Power Ranger. But then when he wanted to take the sticky hat, it was like, his name's Emerus. I'm like, Emerus, like, you don't understand. Like, your mommy was a Power Ranger. Like, how do you not want to take mummy to show and tell? So I totally used that card, but he was like, I want a sticky hand. Like, he didn't care.
Yeah. It's like, I see you all the time. Like,
but my oldest son, when he was in kindergarten, grade one, learned that I was a Power Ranger, and he went to school and told his friends, and he thought it was the coolest thing at the time. And his friends didn't believe him. They thought he was fibbing. That is the one time I wish I had the suit, because, you know, it's like you go into like mama bear mode if somebody's like, I don't know, I was just feeling protective, and I'm like, I'm gonna show these kids that he's not lying. But unfortunately we weren't able to keep the suits. I don't have anything other than I literally bought like a Halloween SPD costume one year. So I couldn't prove him right. But anyway,
you pulled Netflix on the phone.
Yeah. yeah I don't think he had a phone then, but yeah. But yeah, anyway.
See, back to conventions, Melody. I know I've seen you at a few conventions. You even worn the astronomer suit.
Oh my God, that was such a big thing for me. I was like, had to gear up for that emotionally for months.
That putting it back on, like, how did that feel?
It was so exciting because I think that the convention goers were really excited. And so I just focused on that and not all of my, you know, insecurities about how I might look any different than I used to or whatever. So, yeah, it really is overwhelming. These conventions, people are just awesome. And the fans, you just realize what a community it is. And so they were very supportive. So that was good. So it ended up being a really positive experience.
How did you get the suit?
I actually, I'm trying to recall her name. I want to look it up right now, but she is this phenomenal cosplayer and she had a gorgeous astronomer suit. I mean, she was an amazing astronomer and she had it made. She made it and gave it to me. So yeah, it was incredibly done.
I've seen pictures of you. I see people like, oh, Throwback Thursday, got a picture of me. Like, yeah, that suit is infamous. People are always posting pictures that they got with you in the suit. They love it.
Oh, seeing those on, I know it's a little bit humbling because it's like, oh my gosh, you know, but it's also just so exciting. Like, people really enjoy it. So that was good. I need to look up, I want to say her name is Jay something Jay. I'm going to look that up and let you guys.
So Allie, we got to get you a suit. That's what we're saying, right? For the next.
Oh, man.
At least a morpher. I got.
Yeah, yeah. Oh,
can I stretch? There we go. We got to get.
We freeze.
Sorry,
I froze for a second. I'm back.
No, I was gonna say we gotta start getting you something. Like, you need a little collection going or something.
Yeah, right. That's awesome. That looks like a real morpher that we actually used, and that's exactly what it was.
Yeah, because you guys used. I mean, you probably still use the toys back then, right? Like the actual.
It was just like it was that.
Let's see. This is the American one. Yeah, it doesn't work. I bought it used years ago, but.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. So
there we go.
I don't have anything, so I feel like I do need to get my hands on some stuff.
We're gonna get it. Well, first off, you have the poster now.
I do. So yeah, it's getting mailed to me. My parents live on the other side of the country, but yes, I will have the poster.
Okay, so we got. Yeah, we'll start with that, and maybe next time you're at a convention, someone will have to hook you up.
Yeah.
With an SPD morpher.
I agree. And I have my figurine that I bought.
It is crazy that they don't even just send you one. Like, hey, by the way, put your face. It's not like it's your character. This is literally your face they put on here. And is it okay? Do you think the sculpt turned out okay? I know, because some people's faces did not turn out the best.
I don't want to get crucified for saying this, but I feel like it doesn't look like me. And I was really a little bit disappointed because I felt like they have access to the best designers and machinery. I'm not sure how they make them. Like, why couldn't they actually take my photo and put it, like, morph it into a figurine, right? Like, it literally was, yeah.
At least there were some, at least they didn't try to give you teeth, because I don't know if you guys saw the pictures of the one, it was Amy Jo Johnson with Kimberly. She's like smiling like this, like, hey, I'm gonna hurt you. Like, these are Power Rangers.
Yeah.
No, so you have blue hair in this one.
Yeah.
And have you heard the news that a purple hair one is coming also?
Okay, I saw some photos that presumably came by way of China. Is this a group with a clip door? That's like so exciting. I feel like I'm the last to know all of this stuff. Like, I'm like, oh, that's super cool. I feel like my figure doesn't quite necessarily resemble me either. But then again, it's like astronomy.
No, it doesn't at all.
Up as astronomer didn't really look. She's intense.
It's all the accessories. Once you get everything else. But yeah, no, if you put this like side by side, I'm like, it doesn't actually look like you at all. Like the nose is way pointier. Like, I don't know, or maybe it's just the makeup, but it looks like your cheekbones like go all the way up to your eye sockets. So although you did have some over the top makeup, I will tell you that.
Well, you did. Awesome.
It was fantastic. Makeup. So I do have to mention this. I've seen the call sheets. Lady Rangers always get the short end of the stick. Cause isn't it like the guys get to show up on set at like 6, but the girls' calls is like 6 or 5:30 or something. You guys always have to be there like a half hour before the guys for stuff for makeup.
Sometimes, but I feel like I shared a ride a lot of the times. Like the driver, we had this two awesome people that would pick us up in the morning and take us home. And often we were in the same van, but I feel like it was a lot of like, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, and then wait, like hurry up and wait, they call it, right? So I feel like we got rushed through hair and makeup probably. And then the guys got to just like a little bit of powder and go take a nap. That was more, you know, but I mean, Melody, it sounds like you had way more than I, so.
Oh my God, I remember driving to the studio at like 4 in the morning. Like nothing's awake. So, but luckily everyone was so lovely. So it wasn't so painful. It could have been way worse.
So did you shoot in LA, Melody?
Yeah, I shot north of Los Angeles in Santa Clarita.
Okay, so you obviously, I think when I filmed, they had moved the series recently to New Zealand out of the States, right? Which was super cool. But I think there's obviously a lot of differences between production.
Mm-hmm. Oh gosh, I would have loved to have filmed in New Zealand. That would be amazing. I got to go there for Legendary Battle and it was just, oh, I love that trip so much. It was wonderful.
Such a great country. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And yeah, and you've gotten to come back for the Legendary Battle, and it even got to have a nice throwback to the fact that you were evil too, which was a nice surprise that I think all of us Ranger fans who, you know, as older Ranger fans who had seen the seasons past, to see just that little bit of like, I love being a Ranger. We all, it was, you know, Ranger Nation just went, oh, we get that. I get that reference.
Yeah, that was so cool. And it was really cool filming it.
So Liz, maybe you can shed some light on this for me, because I was part of the Disney era, and I think that Disney era, there's 5 series, I believe, in the Disney era, got left behind a little bit because, and maybe that's whole like Saban sold to Disney, Disney sold back to Saban, and then I don't know if it has to do with like rights and monetary stuff, but basically we didn't get to do a team up my year. So we did a team up with the year before, but then we didn't get to do a team up. And then it just seemed like that kind of Disney era just kind of got left out a little bit, kind of moving forward.
Yeah, there was definitely some differences, like the lack of team ups, and after a while, and then eventually whenever Disney was like, we're just going to get rid of the season, they stopped promoting RPM. They moved it to like 5 a.m. or something, and we're like, and we're done. And that's when Saban bought the brand back. And then he was like, hey, this is my baby. We're just going to start back with Mighty Morphin again and all this new stuff. And then he was kind of like poo-poo. And we never got anything from the Disney seasons, which made us fans of the Disney seasons be like, okay, for real. Like, you've got to give us something. So we're excited that we're finally getting something that's not Mighty Morphin. Because it's power. Let's be honest. It's Power Rangers. It's like, oh, I was the Pink Ranger. Oh, were you Mighty Morphin Pink?
Yeah.
Oh my God. So no.
People are always so confused. Like, you're the Power Ranger, like Kimberly.
Kimberly.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that happens all the time.
Did they? Yeah, because they're like, oh, it's the Pink. Was it the first one? No. Second one? No. How many? Well, it was a Power Ranger for like 10 years. You're like, oh, sweetie. Oh, sweetie. Power Rangers has been on for almost celebrating 30 years this year.
Yeah, amazing.
30 years. August 28th is National Power Rangers Day in America, and it is celebrating its 30th birthday.
Wow.
So
that's a lot of Power Rangers.
how does that feel when you're like, I got to be a part of a series that's, is it your 30 year long Power Rangers? Like, what does that mean to you when you realize, like, oh, it's this big to be a part of it?
You know, I'm no longer acting, so I'm no longer in the industry. And I think that when I stepped out of the industry, I really embraced how freaking cool it is that I got to be a Power Ranger. And I feel like, and I don't want to speak for anybody else, my assumption is that others that have gone on to act and do really well in the industry don't necessarily like hold on to that history as closely as someone that's outside of the industry now, because I look at it from like a fan perspective. I was a fan of Power Rangers as a child, and how cool is it that I got to be the Pink Power Ranger? So I've really embraced that and just feel so grateful and happy that I got to be a part of this community and this series. And I feel like you said, when I stepped outside of acting, I just had a different perspective. And it's freaking awesome.
I agree. I feel that when I was doing the show, I had an idea of the part it would play in my life. And it wasn't until so many years later when I started engaging with the fans at conventions that I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so and it's come to play this like very dear part of my life that I don't know. It's really enriched my life in a way. I mean, it's such a unique experience. So similar feelings. I just look at this. I just feel gratitude. It was very incidental. It wasn't like I was like, I want to be a Power Ranger. Like it happened. And now I'm like, oh my gosh. Oh, very lucky.
Yeah. It's surreal. Same thing. When we were filming, actually at the time in New Zealand, Power Rangers did not air in New Zealand. They still don't. Wow.
So not to my knowledge.
Knew in New Zealand what Power Rangers were. So it was kind of like nice. You can kind of go under the radar and just film and no one, you know, bothered us. And then I had no idea, like Melody said, what the community would be, and that there's this amazing and massive community of people. And what I love is that there's people that have been fans since the original series and have continued watching it throughout. So, you know, I get to have awesome conversations at these conventions when I do get to go. And then I also love the kids. I mean, I melt when there's kids that come up and watch SPD, because SPD was years ago now, and actually check it out on Netflix. And it's just honestly, grateful. It's awesome.
That's fantastic. I did get a note. I was wrong. Apparently, Power Rangers turns 30 in 2 years. It's 28 this year.
Okay.
My bad. Everybody in chat who is probably like, dear Liz, this is strike three. It's over. Man. That's it. Although we are getting to about 45 minutes, and this Power Morphicon Online, it's here because we can't be here together physically. So I hope that everybody out there watching this is at least getting to enjoy a little bit of everyone and our Rangers and getting to be part of this community. It really is just counting down the days, the hours, until we can all get together again and celebrate this and just see the cosplay, see the kids, see everybody just together again. And that's soon, right? We all do our part. Fingers crossed. We should be good.
Mm-hmm. Aw, thank you, Liz. You're awesome, and I hope you feel better.
Oh, thank you. I tried to hold that one in as I hack over. But I just want to say thank you so much, Melody, Allie, for allowing me to chat with you. This was my first ever like Ranger interview like this. So this is really special to me. And I want to say thanks to Joe and for the Illuminati to reaching out when they say, hey, we have a Women of Power Rangers panel. You want to do it, because I'm a woman Power Ranger fan. So it meant a lot to me to just get to talk to you ladies kind of this one-on-one. And yeah, again, thanks to Joe, thanks to the Illuminati and to Power Morphicon Online for hosting this. Until we can all meet again, thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you, Liz. Thank you, Power Morphicon.
Yeah.